Good morning, everybody. Praise the Lord. It's a beautiful Sunday morning. And as I always say, every day is a blessed day that we wake up and we take a breath. Woo! God enabled us to make it through the night. We are so close to death when we're asleep because we are the most vulnerable. We can't control anything. You know, I mean, oh, it's just amazing how powerful God is and how he keeps us. But what I wanted to encourage someone with on this morning, as I was driving to church, the Lord put it on my heart to share that it's time to let it all go. It's time to let it all go. That family member that you're not talking to, that person that you are holding that grudge against, it is time to let it all go. Thank you, Holy Spirit. It's time to let it all go. And someone who hears this message, it's going to prick your heart because I know the Holy Spirit. I feel him so strong right now. It's time to let it all go. It's time to release it in Jesus' name. God wants to do something amazing in your life. And he said, I can't do it until you let it go. I will not release those blessings until you let it go. I am holding many great things for you in my hands. But until you let that go, I cannot release it. You are in control of the blessings that are released in your life. You are the one that holds it. You are the one that's in control. All we have to do is surrender our lives to Jesus. I'm trying to tell you something here. When you release your life, when you give your life to him and you let him come in and do that work in your life, the blessings will come. The blessings are going to overtake you. You all, there are so many things going on that God has allowed to happen that are still going on. Just blessing after blessing after blessing. After blessing, I'm telling you, there is a life that God has for you, but you have to let it go this morning. God is never saying that what happened to you, what that person did to you, is that you're not justified in your anger, that you're not justified in the way that you feel. But what he is saying is that my grace is sufficient. What he is saying is that I have forgiven you, my child, for many things, things that you don't even know that you've done. I have blotted out your transgression. So he is asking you to extend the same grace. He is asking you to forgive that person just like he forgave you. Oh, thank you, Holy Spirit. I hope you all have an amazing day. I got to get in church. I stepped outside of church. It hasn't started yet, but I stepped out to share this message with you. So be blessed on today. Amen.